Hey everyone, Pete Estes here. Welcome to another episode of Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. We've got plenty of soccer in today's show, and we'll start on the men's side with a weekly award for Justin Freitas. Freitas scored both of Vermont's goals in a 2-0 shutout win over Binghamton last weekend en route to America East Player of the Week honors. Freitas ranks second in the league in total scoring with 19 points and goals with 8 this season. Last night, the Cats played number 20 New Hampshire to a 1-1 draw to clinch the league's regular season championship outright for the first time since 2012. UVM will be the number one seed in the conference tournament and receives a bye to the semifinals, where it will play either UMBC or Albany next Wednesday night at 7 o'clock right here at Virtue Field. The America East also announced postseason awards for field hockey earlier this week. Junior forward Landon Warren earned a spot on the East Division All-Conference team after scoring 14 goals this season, the fifth most in a single season at UVM. Meanwhile, junior captain Olivia Hurd found a spot on the All-Academic team for the second straight season. Hurd has started all but one game in her Catamount career. Well, if you watched last night's men's soccer game at UNH, you might have noticed some new haircuts for the Cats. Players and staff recently partnered with the St. Baldrick's Foundation, a childhood cancer research foundation, and shaved their heads to show their support.
I had someone reach out to me who was part of St. Baldrick's Foundation, looking to see if there'd be athletic team that wanted to partner with them, and our guys were fully about it. So we first had 5 guys that were willing to shave their heads, and then it went to 10, then it went to 15, and virtually the whole team is now partaking in it, so it's pretty cool. It benefits pediatric cancer research, and that money that's raised is going directly to Vermont Cancer Research Funds in Vermont, which is pretty cool.
It's important for us to bring some attention to this disease that I don't think gets enough attention, and helps to raise money and also give back to the community.
Needing a win and some help to qualify for the America East Tournament 2 weeks ago, the women's soccer team has since made the most of its third straight trip to the conference playoffs. Now, the team stands just one win away from its first trip to the NCAA Tournament since 1984. Catamount TV caught up with head coach Christy Lefebvre to talk about Sunday's league title game down on Long Island.
Stony Brook's a great team. Obviously, you know, we had a tough battle here with them at the end of the season. They had clinched already. We hadn't. We were fighting for a spot. We were home. They were away. It's not an easy trip for either of us to make, either for them up to here or us down to there. So we fully expect it to be a different game down there, especially with such high stakes. But they've been great on the road, too. So we have momentum, but so do they. So we're just expecting a really fun, competitive game.
Before heading down to Long Island for some women's soccer action Sunday, be sure to get to Patrick Gym on Saturday. Start out in the pool as swimming and diving host Maine in its annual Rally Against Cancer meet presented by Otter Creek Awnings and Vermont Custom Closets. Action starts at noon. Then head up to Patrick for the annual basketball doubleheader against crosstown rival St. Michael's. Women's action gets underway at 4:30 and the men follow at 7. Fans are encouraged to bring a canned good to the game in exchange for a cookie from Trader Duke's Hotel on Williston Road. Thanks for tuning in for another busy episode of Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. As always, plenty more next week right here on Catamount TV.